done one video, terrible audio to it. It's gonna be good. I got 3 more to do, and not a lot of time to do them, so we're gonna keep rolling, I guess. In this video, we are doing practices of looking. The practice of looking in cinema, which is gonna be good. I'll follow the same format as the last video. Try to sort of describe what I'm talking about, and then compare and contrast two separate. I'm not really comparing and contrasting, and then sort of talk about how it plays out in two separate films. So the practice of looking is sort of how you direct the viewer's gaze onto a subject, how you sort of build up the image of this thing in the viewer's mind. It's kind of hard to explain, but I think it'll sort of come out in how I talk about the two films. So, Dennis O'Rourke in 1988 created a movie, Cannibal Tours. And in it, what you see is a bunch of tourists fetishizing this exotic culture. You see them paying a vast amount of money to travel to this landscape far from home to pick up a bunch of pointless to them trinkets, because they all sort of represent this thing, this tangible thing, that being namely cannibals. So these people are going out of their way to sort of interact with these cannibal villages. And the way that, and my sentiment at the moment, it kind of plays with how Dennis O'Rourke describes the tourists and how he sort of builds up how the viewer looks upon the cannibal tourists, or the tourists. So O'Rourke wants the viewer of the film to sort of ask the question, who is really the cannibal? Is it the people who historically ate people, or is it these tourists coming to feed off of this broken and subjugated culture? And so he sort of angles the way that the viewer looks at it through interview scenes where he gets people to say sort of what he wants them to say. Not like belligerently. He like asks questions and gets sort of like the perfect audio to sort of demonstrate how, I guess, ignorant these people are, and how they're sort of unaware of what they're actually doing, and how destructive and damaging to the native peoples it is and it can be. In similar fashion, in 1993, a film called The Couple in the Cage was made that featured a man and a woman dressed up in sort of ridiculous outfits, pretending to be an Aboriginal couple, pretending to be a native couple from a small island off the Gulf of Mexico, and they toured around the United States, sort of getting the lay of the land. They created this negative image, or they created this non-positive image of the Americans by controlling what the viewer saw in aspect of all of these different people doing this horribly ridiculous thing. For instance, they were happy to pay to have the woman dance, or have the man remove his gown and be nude for half a second or so. These people were completely content with having these two individuals in a cage, which is just horribly wrong, and sort of shows, and the sort of point of the video is to show how in America it's relatively acceptable, or was relatively acceptable at the time, for people to be denigrated, to be put below Americans without much complaint, without much problem.